Don't you ever get to the point where you should not only be skeptical but cynical that this UN will ever act, or even that the state parties will ever act? Fine, you have this petition. Fine, you're calling upon people to act. But aren't you cynical as to whether they will really act at all? Look at the past horrors, and that should tell you the story. And I say, if we look at the past horrors, the unspeakable horror, not only the genocide, but that these genocides were preventable, and we have a chance now to prevent a genocide, then if the state parties do not act, and if the United Nations does not act, then they will, in effect, sound a fatal blow against the whole corpus of international law, United Nations, international instruments, and the like, including what we have referred to as the Never Again Convention, namely the Genocide Convention. We are approaching the 60th anniversary of that convention. Now is the time for the state parties to act. And I will say this, that if our petition serves no other purpose, through the exposing the critical mass of evidence in Ahmadinejad's state-sanctioned incitement to genocide, and through the identification of the remedies to be taken, if it serves no other purpose, then at least making the world aware that we do have a genocidal process on the way, that we do have and can prevent it, at least we will be saying at this point, number one, we will be showing solidarity with the victims, not only prospective victims of the Iranian, but our remembrance of victims in Rwanda and Darfur. We will, at the same time, as Iranians themselves tell me, we will be emboldening the victims in Iran itself to tell them they are not alone with respect to Ahmadinejad's regime. We will be emboldening progressive forces in Iran that, yes, maybe there are those who are speaking out and alerting the international community, not only with regard to the impending genocide, but also with regard to the kind of massive repression and danger of a nuclear as well as genocidal Iran and a rights-oppressing Iran. We may be able to delegitimate Ahmadinejad not only internationally but domestically. That too can embolden civil society in Iran. By exposing the critical mass of evidence of the state-sanctioned incitement to genocide, the precursors to genocide, that which acts as both prologue and justification for genocide, perhaps this can act as a wake-up call to the state parties in the international community, the United Nations and the like, to exercise their responsibility to prevent. And so I close by saying that the time has come not only to think but to act in terms of prevention rather than intervention after the fact, after the genocide occurs, after it's too late. In terms of accountability, not a culture of impunity which encourages the perpetrators to continue with their incitement. In terms of action, and not in terms of indifference or inaction, which also serves to encourage the perpetrators. If we fail to act so as to prevent a genocidal nuclear Iran, we will embolden not only Iran, but others as well, and we will embolden perpetrators everywhere to believe that they can get away with it. That they got away with it in Rwanda, they're getting away with it in Darfur, they can get away with it in Iran and beyond. And this constitutes a threat not only to Israel and the Jewish people, not only to the Middle East of a destabilizing Ahmadinejad's Iran, but to international peace and security.